When creating and updating work orders, we can include procedures for the person completing the work order to follow. Let's learn how to include procedures on a work order. Here, we've got a work order that we are in the process of creating. The work order requires the inspection of the fire extinguisher in the interior assembly building at our facility. The work order is already linked to the right location and specifies maintenance for the appropriate asset. Now we'll add the procedure that includes the steps for the inspection. Since the procedure template is associated with the asset on this work order, it appears as a relevant template in the menu. Now that we've included this procedure on the work order, the maintenance technician that gets assigned to the work order can simply follow the steps. It is also possible to create procedures from a work order. Let's say we're creating a work order and we realize we don't have the appropriate procedure template to pick from. We could simply select the option to create a new procedure directly from the procedure menu. This will open the procedure editor where we can add in the necessary fields and then include it on our work order. If we are creating a procedure from a work order and we want to be able to reuse that procedure as a procedure template, we would check the Save to Procedure Library checkbox at the bottom of the editor.